My dearest Sarah, forgive me for my silence. There are so many difficulties. I have now reached a decision, so meet me at the rocks at 6 tonight. Thomas.
Come as a shock to us all. But in the 12 years you've been with us, I can honestly say that nobody has worked harder or been more reliable than you. And as you can imagine, no one's sorrier than I am to be in this position now. You will receive, of course, a first-class reference from us, and as I believe you already know, a substantial redundancy payment, which I'm confident you'll know how to make the best use of. Best of luck to you.
So, if we sold the house, and with the redundancy money, we could buy somewhere up here, you know.
Yeah, that'd be beautiful.
So what do you think?
What do I think? I suggested it. I'm putting up the sign.
That's the lot then. Thanks. That's great.
Quite an effect that.
Right. Say that again.
Yeah, quite an effect that, wasn't it, lads?
Yeah.
Here we are then. Thanks a lot.
That's great. Thanks.
Okay. Right. We'll be going then.
Right, see you.
See you then.
Thanks,
guys.
Bye-bye.
Can I go and say bye-bye?
Yeah, of course you can. Go on, off you go. Well, here we are then.
A lot of work though, you know.
Yeah, well, I've got the time then. I'm going to enjoy it.
Thank you. Not again.
I'm up here. I'm just sorting out this light from the living room.
The living room light?
Yeah, it keeps going out.
You what?
I said the light keeps going out.
Must be the wiring.
You all right?
Doing this.
I've been working.
A bit early for that, isn't it?
Well, we're still celebrating, aren't we?
Now, what is it this time?
Apricot.
Mm-hmm. Cheers.
Cheers.
Oh, stuff blows your head off.
Here we are, then.
Aye. Bloody place needs rewiring.
Well, you knew that. Oh, while I was shopping today, I passed the job centre and had a look.
Job centre?
Yeah. I went in.
What for?
Well, I saw a job advertised in the window.
What, for me?
No, for me.
Hmm. What sort of job?
Secretarial, typing.
You don't want to go back to that, do you?
Well, why not? You just said yourself, the whole place needs rewiring. We've got to get money from somewhere to do it, haven't we?
Well, yeah.
Come on, Vicky, we're going to be late. Yes, put your coat on.
I'm going to get my teddy.
Yeah, you go fetch it then. Okay.
You got everything then?
Yeah. Mwah. Will you do the washing up for me then?
Oh, I might manage to do that for you, yeah.
Please.
Ta-ta.
Bye.
See ya.
Come on, Vicky.
Bye, Daddy.
Bye, Steve.
Bye. Ta-ra.
can I help you?
Yes. Do you have any books on the history of local mills?
Local mills? I think I can sort you out with one or two of those.
Where have you been?
Oh, nowhere. I've just been up.
What do you mean, nowhere? You've been out all day. It's 8 o'clock. Where have you been?
Just been out.
Where to? I came on to a right mess. Well, where have you been?
I told you. Nowhere.
Come on, Vicky. It's time for bed. Mrs. Greenwood, please.
And several accusations of witchcraft. However, the circumstances surrounding the disappearance or death of Thomas Schofield and the young mill girl remain a mystery. The effect on Thomas's father, Alfred, was devastating. In November 1887, he closed down the Schofield Mill and remained in seclusion until his death.
Hello there.
Hello.
Do you have any newspapers or anything dating back to 1887?
Local or national?
Local.
Oh, yes. There were two local papers in Calderdale, the Courier and the Halifax Guardian. We have copies dating back to 1832. It's all on microfilm. Would you like to follow me?
Yes, thanks. That's it. October 1887.
Mind me escorting you home.
Fascinating, isn't it?
Steve, where the hell have you been?
Oh, well, I'm here.
Where's Vicky? Did you pick her up from school?
No, she's...
No, what do you mean, no? Where is she?
It's all right. Barbara picked her up. They'll be back about 8 o'clock.
Where have you been all day? It's 6 o'clock, Steve. I've been worried sick. Where have you been?
Just been into town.
Are you going to ask me then?
Nice.
The job. I got the job, Steve. Don't you care? What have you been doing in town, anyway? Aye, I'm still here. Why don't you leave me a note? I was worried, you know.
Sorry.
How are you, Steve? Don't look like it. What's happened anyway? Am I included in this or what? Have I done something wrong?
Evening. Everything all right?
Okay, it's fine.
You're looking a bit tired. Yeah. Been walking, I suppose. Yeah. Why don't you come and sit down over here, eh? That's better, sir. Easy, does it?
Sorry to be trouble.
Don't worry yourself, love. Just give him a couple of minutes to calm himself down. I've seen it before, it's just shock. He'll be all right.
I don't know what happened.
Oh, sorry. Oh, I'm sorry.
Don't worry, sir. Just take a few deep breaths and relax. You're among friends now.
Oh, I feel daft. Bloody daft.
You feeling a bit better now, sir?
I just feel embarrassed.
You think this is embarrassing? Do you know some things have happened to me? Hey, I'll tell you one time, right? I'll bet you've never seen a flying saucer.
You what?
Yeah, seriously. You try telling people that and see the sort of reaction you get. It's just up this road, actually, a few miles further on. I was on duty, right? Riding along, and I saw this, what I thought was this bus, parked sideways on in the middle of the road. Then I realised, like, you don't get buses floating 5 feet off the ground. So I stopped about 20 yards away from it, and I just sat there for ages, just staring at it. And then I started to really panic, and got on the radio, and nothing worked. Then, the next thing I remember, I'm riding along about 40, 50 yards further down the road. I look round, nothing, completely gone.
Is that right? You're not having us on?
I only wish I was. No, it's been in all the papers and everything. Still don't believe it myself. But believe me, if it happens to you, it doesn't matter if you believe in it or not. Come on, sir. Tell me we're getting you home, eh?
I'm with child.
But it bears a lesson to us. As to the distance and sense of position we must always maintain with the workers. And a pride in the family name, which we must always hold close. There's 10 guineas. You receive regular money. You're not starved.
I don't want your money.
Money's all you'll get. You're not but a child.
Can't. Where is he now?
He's upstairs. Locked himself in the spare room.
And he said nothing at all to you about why he's behaving like this?
No. He just keeps talking to himself.
And what does he say?
He says, I've got to find her.
Has anything happened to him recently which might have caused this? Obviously, having been made redundant, but anything else?
We're moving house, but we're both happy about that.
Has he been violent at all?
No.
Has he ever been violent in the past?
Never.
Have you mentioned my visit at all?
I said go away.
Stephen?
I'm Dr. Austin, from the health centre. I've just come to have a word.
What for?
Because I'm worried about you, Steve.
Well, would you like to come out and talk to us? Well, can I come in and have a word?
The thing is, Stephen, if you talk about it, maybe that'll help.
Have you talked to that policeman about flying saucers?
What policeman's that?
Local Bobby's seen a flying saucer.
No, I haven't spoken to him. What are you trying to say, Stephen?
Well, nobody believes him, do they?
Look, I'm a doctor. I hear things that people think are ridiculous.
But they don't sound ridiculous to me. The ridiculous part of it is that they couldn't talk about it in the first place. Usually to the person who it's most important to talk to.
Those books are?
Yeah.
I've been watching you. You've been tearing pages out of that book.
No. It was done already.
Can I have the pages, please?
You don't understand. It's all right.
It isn't all right.
No, you see, I need them. It's quite all right.
Look, just give me the pages.
All right. There.
Thank you.
either.
How are you feeling today?
Fine.
You didn't come for your appointment, so I thought I'd drop round and see how you were.
No, I went to the library.
Library?
To renew a book.
Is your wife in?
Yes.
Do you mind if I come in? Hello, Mrs. Greenwood. I had a call up this way, so I thought I'd come and see how you were. Did you have that prescription made up?
Don't need it.
Well, I wouldn't have prescribed it if I hadn't thought it was necessary. It might help, in the short term. Well, have you sorted out whatever it was that was bothering you?
Oh, yeah.
And you feel all right about it?
Yeah.
You're not going to lock yourself upstairs again?
No.
And what about the policeman and the flying saucers?
Just a policeman.
You see, if you do have problems about anything, sometimes it's easier talking to somebody who's not personally involved. I've seen it before. Moving into a new house, new environment, one can imagine many things. The pressures of moving, extra financial worries, leaving old friends, having to make new friends. Have you made any new friends yet?
Yes.
Good. Good, that'll help. It's always important to be able to talk to friends. And it's good to know that you can count on the support of your family. Isn't that right, Mrs. Greenwood?
It's all right now. I think you should go. We can sort this out ourselves.
Of course. I'll leave you to do that then.
She's a nice lady. She's going to take you to the rock.
I have now reached a decision. So meet me at the rocks at 6 tonight. Thomas.
Thank you. was wrong. We can.
The palace had come to life again after its sleep of 100 years. Around the palace, the high hedge vanished. A wonderful wedding feast was prepared. The handsome prince was married to Sleeping Beauty, and they lived happily ever after. There. And now it's time for this beauty to go to sleep. All right? Well, lie down.